beyond agriculture, we have zeroed in again on infrastructural development. Plans are on the way to refurbish Lungi International Airport. We are negotiating with port managers for the entire management of ports to be privatized to ensure that we use the potential that we have there to the fullest, because we have a natural harbor that is unique in the West Coast, and we believe that if it is utilized to the fullest, there will be possibilities not only to shorten the time of our shipment facilities, but for Freetown to serve as a transshipment port for the South region. Now we are working on, in infrastructural development, we are working on the road infrastructure, because we believe that the road infrastructure will facilitate the recovery of the economy, and it will also help the increase in agricultural productivity. That is why, as a government, when we came, we ensured that we have revived all the projects that were abandoned, the old road construction projects that were abandoned. Those have been revived, and even the 47 Cambia Road, I'm sure by the end of the rains, we will have it to start again. The Peninsula Road will be completed shortly, and the for the construction of the Kenema Kailong Road as the first phase. We will move on to the second phase of the Kailong Kwengu Road. Now, we are also addressing the issues of improving the road situation in Freetown and the rest of the country. But I am not a politician that goes around making empty promises. I believe that I believe it is best for us to spring surprises. But I want to assure you that we are working on the area of road infrastructure. Now, as a government, we have agreed on limited priorities. We don't believe we have to spread out. When you spread out too thin, the impact will not be effective. So that is why our focus is on energy, agriculture, and infrastructure. These are the key areas. We believe with these areas, we can lay the basis for a turnaround in the economy. We can improve on our social delivery services of education and health. And we believe that Sierra Leone will be the kind of destination that will attract everybody. Now, one area we believe we have to add on to the three is developing our tourist potential. Now, tourism has a great potential in the country. You all know it. What is required is for us to have the proper touristic infrastructure, and that requires investment. We are attracting a lot of investors. We are negotiating with the owners of the hotels, and we believe that very soon, NACIT will help us with the reconstruction of one of the oldest hotels in the country to make it again to a five-star hotel, that is the Kibsera Hotel. Now we are working on all of this. We are doing so with great difficulty. We have tried in the first place to get around that difficulty by restoring confidence in the country. We're living at a time when even our donor partners were not prepared to continue to provide the support that would normally be given to the government. We have restored that. The IMF is back. The World Bank is back. The EU is back. DFID is back. And we have restored confidence, not only to these institutions and countries, we have also restored confidence even to important political and economic leaders of the world. You must have heard that Tony Blair visited us. George Soros has visited us. Gildof has visited us. Alhaji Dangote has visited us. All of them are coming because of the renewed confidence they have in the government. But what it means is that we need support from the international community. We need support from our donor partners. We need support from Sierra Leoneans in the diaspora. To demonstrate our willingness to work with Sierra Leoneans in the diaspora, we have opened a diaspora office under the presidency. And our expectations are that we have appreciated the support that you have been sending to the Leoneans in the diaspora. Been sending $100, many homes are surviving there out of the remittances that you are sending out. But I believe in this moment of reconstructing the country, during this moment, we want great things to happen. We have appealed to our donor partners that we don't want to think small. The small thinking has not helped us. We are beginning to think big. We don't want we appreciate the hundreds of thousands and the millions over the years. But now we believe that the only thing that can help us to create an impact that will get Sierra Leone out of the woods will be billions of dollars. If we have to heal our roads, if we have to irrigate our land, if we have to translate the 1,200 megawatts potential that the country has into real electricity, if we have to educate our children, if we have to reduce the terrible mortality rates that we are now experiencing in the country, it involves a huge capital injection. Huge capital injection. We have appealed to our donors to work with us, and I believe this is an opportunity for me to appeal to Sierra Leoneans in the diaspora to start thinking big. Other countries have experienced a turnaround principally because of the contributions they have enjoyed from their fellow citizens from the diaspora. And you are so important to us that we believe we cannot do it alone. So we want you to contribute in turning around the economy, get yourselves into groups, form companies, engage in the private sector, and ensure that the hundreds of thousands that you have been sending out is translated to millions, so that even the Lunga Bridge can be a diaspora project.